Embarking on an odyssey through the intricate realm of nuclear fusion, we encounter the visionary force, driving Helion Energy's audacious mission to reshape the energy landscape. Their pursuit hinges on creating affordable, sustainable fusion generators capable of illuminating homes across the world. Yet, this journey goes beyond mere ambition, plunging into the profound science of fusion reactions, the tantalizing potential of atoms converging to release boundless energy, forging a path to a cleaner, more sustainable future. This narrative unravels the fusion saga, from the minuscule interactions of subatomic particles to the colossal promise of limitless power, poised at the cusp of commercialization through strategic innovation, collaborative efforts, and unyielding determination. Meet David, the visionary behind Helion Energy's quest to revolutionize energy production. So what's their ambition? Creating affordable, sustainable fusion generators that promise abundant and safe electricity. Helion is committed to scaling up their technology, envisioning 50 megawatt generators that could soon power homes worldwide, reshaping the future of energy sooner than anticipated. The quest for the Holy Grail of energy is centered around one key concept: fusion. Imagine an energy source that's endless, environmentally friendly, space efficient, and supremely safe. Fusion power, a cutting-edge experimental approach that harnesses the energy generated when two atomic nuclei merge, checks all these boxes. Since the 1950s, scientists have explored fusion's potential, managing to create fusion reactions in controlled laboratory conditions. Yet, translating this concept into practical electricity generation remains elusive. The possibilities are astounding. Merely a gram of Helion's fusion fuel, deuterium, can power a home for a year. Notably, this fuel is virtually boundless, found in trace amounts within the Earth's water sources. Traditionally, the fuels explored for fusion involve isotopes of hydrogen, protium, deuterium, and tritium. However, Helion Energy has ventured into more promising fusion reactions. By combining deuterium and helium-3, an uncommon isotope of helium, they produce helium-4, along with a tremendous surge of electricity. To truly understand fusion, we explore the astonishingly minuscule realm of atoms. Atoms, the fundamental building blocks of matter, consist of nuclei and electrons. Zooming in on the nucleus, we encounter protons and neutrons, with nuclei bearing a positive charge due to the neutrality of neutrons. When atoms are heated to extreme temperatures, they shed their electrons, forming a charged particle cloud known as plasma. Within this plasma, atoms are in constant motion, vibrating and colliding. As plasma density increases, collisions between nuclei become more likely. However, the positively charged nuclei repel each other upon approaching too closely. The temperature of the plasma dictates the speed of charged particles, and heightened particle velocity translates to greater kinetic energy. When the collision speed overrides electrostatic repulsion, the nuclei draw close enough to experience a potent attractive force called nuclear strong force, leading to fusion. The fusion process entails the merger of two lightweight nuclei to form a heavier element, releasing energy equivalent to the missing mass, often far exceeding that of burning fuel fossils. In the sun's core, gravitational forces create immense pressures, compressing elements to densities surpassing even the heaviest metals, and temperatures that exceed 15 million degrees Celsius, ideal conditions for hydrogen fusion into helium. Our world relies on diverse energy sources. Photosynthesis transforms sunlight into chemical energy, fossil fuels are combusted for energy, and solar radiation propels wind and water energy generation. Nuclear fusion stands as a colossal yet challenging opportunity to vertically integrate energy production. To achieve artificial fusion, we must overcome incredible hurdles. While the sun benefits from colossal gravitational forces and billions of years worth of fuel, artificial fusion demands even higher temperatures and greater efficiency. In the confines of an artificial fusion setup, a plasma of such heat that it can vaporize anything it contacts must be contained. Furthermore, this chaotic thermonuclear reaction must be harnessed to generate more energy than is lost to the environment. As we navigate the complexities of fusion, we edge closer to a future where the Holy Grail of energy becomes reality. It's a journey that pushes the boundaries of science, technology, and innovation, offering a glimpse into a world where limitless and sustainable energy sources power our lives. But we thought, how does Helion Energy's innovative fusion approach eliminate the need for mechanical devices that convert kinetic energy to energy generation? So we dive deeper. Helion Energy introduces an innovative method to address the challenge of abundant energy. Their key solution lies within these vividly glowing purple rings, propelled at speeds surpassing 1 million miles per hour. Fusion, the process of merging atoms, offers various paths to success. Magnetic fusion involves sustaining a blazing plasma within a stable magnetic field until it ignites into a self-sustaining fusion reaction. In contrast, inertial confinement fusion seeks higher plasma densities by rapidly compressing and heating minuscule fusion fuel targets, often employing high-energy lasers to achieve fusion in a mere billionth of a second. Bridging these realms, magneto-inertial fusion combined with magnetic confinement with rapid compression and heating, as showcased in Helion's field reverse configuration. What sets Helion's approach apart is their plan to generate electricity without the need for boiling water to produce steam for turbines. Traditional methods of fusion power often rely on steam turbines to convert heat into electricity, but Helion aims to eliminate this step. With their innovative magneto-inertial fusion technique, the plasma is magnetically confined and rapidly energized through compression, leading to a fusion event in just around 1/1000th of a second. We believe this groundbreaking approach sidesteps the necessity of boiling water, offering a more direct and efficient method of electricity generation. Helion's fusion strategy encapsulates the best of both worlds, propelling us closer to achieving the long-sought dream of limitless and sustainable energy. By removing the need for steam turbines, Helion's approach could revolutionize the field of fusion power, making it an even more promising solution for our energy needs. To truly grasp the groundbreaking nature of Helion Energy's pursuit of net electricity gain, it's vital to explain the parallels between conventional nuclear fission power and various fusion approaches. In modern nuclear power plants, reactors split heavy nuclear fuels like uranium-235, releasing significant heat energy. Despite their operation since 1951, these nuclear power plants continue to employ the age-old process of converting heat into electricity, a method that dates back to the 19th century. Diverse thermal energy sources, including fossil fuels, geothermal, biofuels, and concentrated solar power, rely on electromagnetic induction to convert rotational motion into electricity. These principles also underlie numerous experimental power generation methods based on fusion. Helion Energy, however, offers a striking departure, a novel approach that draws inspiration from ancient concepts. Pioneers in the 1950s and 60s envisioned the direct extraction of electricity from fusion plasma, tapping into the energy stored in magnetic fields and charged particles. Yet the technological landscape of that time fell short of realizing this concept's potential. Exclusive access granted to electric future to Helion's offers an unprecedented view into the construction of Polaris, offering unparalleled insights into the intricate blend of science and engineering propelling this innovative venture forward. The fusion journey with Helion Energy commences with the formation of plasma, the fourth state of matter characterized by ionized particles. Tiny quantities of Helion's fusion fuels, deuterium and helium-3, are injected into a specialized chamber as a gas. These fusion fuels are then subjected to a process of superheating, transforming them into plasma. This transformation is achieved through the use of oscillating magnetic fields, akin to the principles behind microwave technology. The remarkable aspect of this stage is the generation of plasma under high temperatures and magnetic fields, necessitating the use of specialized materials like fused silica quartz to withstand the extreme conditions. Once the fusion fuels transition into the plasma state, the next phase involves adding energy to create the conditions required for fusion reactions. Helion Energy employs a remarkable combination of electromagnets and capacitor banks to achieve this crucial objective. The electromagnets are responsible for running large currents, often in the order of millions of amps, through the fusion fuel. This current generates immense magnetic fields that compress and heat the plasma, a pivotal step towards achieving fusion. To provide the required megaamp of current, capacitor banks are charged with electrical energy for a few seconds, followed by a rapid discharge of this stored energy into the electromagnets wrapped around the fusion device. Helion Energy's fusion process thrives on the electromagnetic properties of plasma. This then leads to a remarkable phenomenon known as the field-reversed configuration, FRC, where the plasma's magnetic fields wrap around itself, creating a toroidal structure. Unlike traditional fusion approaches that rely on externally generated magnetic fields, the FRC relies on the plasma's self-generated magnetic fields, resulting in a self-organized and stable plasma configuration. This unique design enables compression, heating, and controlled movement of the fusion fuel, a feature that distinguishes Helion's approach and enhances the efficiency of the fusion process. With the FRCs formed on both ends of the fusion device, Helion Energy employs a sequence of powerful electromagnets to accelerate the FRCs toward each other at speeds exceeding 1 million miles per hour. This acceleration, often likened to squeezing toothpaste out of a tube, is achieved through a peristaltic acceleration mechanism. By increasing the magnetic field behind the fusion fuel, a pressure is exerted that propels the plasma forward. This acceleration is achieved through a meticulously designed series of electromagnets that are strategically positioned to guide and accelerate the FRCs. But a significant challenge in fusion technology lies in finding materials that can withstand the intense radiation, electromagnetic radiation, and high-energy neutrons produced during fusion. The fusion chamber's first wall, which separates the plasma from the surrounding components, is particularly vulnerable to these extreme conditions. While fusion systems operate under vacuum conditions to insulate the plasma from the first wall, the intensity of radiation and particles presents a material science challenge that Helion Energy and the fusion community at large are working to overcome. Helion Energy's pioneering efforts are fueled by a commitment to realize the practical application of fusion power on a commercial scale. The company's relentless dedication to building, testing, and iterating fusion systems underscores their belief that commercial fusion power is not a distant dream, but an engineering challenge that can be surmounted. So what exactly is Helion's strategic approach to achieving commercial fusion power, despite lacking material with the structural integrity to sustain their process? The prevailing sentiment in the fusion community is that, while we possess the necessary understanding of the physics and engineering to develop systems capable of producing net energy, the challenge lies in making these systems commercially viable, which I tend to agree with, frankly. The critical questions we must address are, what does the final product entail? Can we streamline its production? Can we drive down the costs? And can we assure a cost-effective entry into the market? In tackling these issues, Helion adopts a production strategy that bears resemblance to Elon Musk's philosophy for Tesla. Numerous experimental fusion approaches often demand substantial capital investment and are inherently large-scale endeavors. While it's true that fusion exhibits favorable scaling characteristics, the larger the system's radius, the more energy it yields and costs tend to decrease, there's a tipping point where practicality diminishes. We envision the establishment of gigafactories tailored for small-scale fusion systems. This approach would allow for mass production at a lower cost, rather than constructing a few monumental one-off fusion power plants. Opting for an assembly of compact generators collectively forming commercially viable fusion systems seems much more feasible. As of April 2023, engineering limitations have hindered nuclear fusion's expansion to the market scales seen in other clean energy alternatives. Nevertheless, we count the top five innovators across the globe that remain committed to tackling this challenge. The National Institute of Fusion Research in Japan houses the world's largest superconducting plasma confinement device, the Large Helical Device, which successfully achieved high heat levels for both ions and electrons in plasma, a crucial step for nuclear fusion reactions. A tokamak, a machine employing powerful magnetic fields to confine superheated plasma for nuclear fusion, faces challenges in maintaining the required temperature and preventing wall melting. Yet a breakthrough superconducting magnet, achieving a record 20 Tesla field strength at MIT's Plasma Science and Fusion Center, has enabled significant progress in facilitating fusion reactions in laboratories, overcoming previous limitations. The Joint European Torus, JET, the world's largest operational tokamak, stands as a key platform for advancing fusion technologies required for widespread nuclear fusion in power grids, being uniquely capable of handling the specific fuel mixture necessary for optimal fusion conditions. The National Ignition Facility, located in Livermore, California, is a powerful laser fusion facility with 192 beams, achieving a net output of energy in 2022, marking a significant step toward commercial nuclear fusion development and positioning the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory as a hub for breakthroughs in this field. The International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor, ITER, project, a collaborative effort of seven International Atomic Energy Agency members, is the world's largest nuclear fusion endeavor, focusing on creating a substantial thermal output and enhancing future reactor productivity through global convergence despite delays. So despite the engineering challenges that have impeded nuclear fusion's expansion to the scales of other clean energy sources, global innovators persevere, making significant strides in overcoming obstacles through breakthroughs such as superconducting plasma confinement devices, record-breaking magnetic fields, and powerful laser fusion facilities, positioning the field for commercial development while collaborative efforts like the ITER project aim to enhance fusion's potential despite delays. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give us a proverbial high five by hitting the like button, and also make sure to comment where you believe fusion energy can be in the next 30 years. Thanks for watching Tech Brilliance TV.